It's a machine learning AI that it's a language-based machine learning AI specifically that was exposed to a lot of data off the internet, most of it up until 2020. It's like an amped up Google search engine in some ways, but it's way beyond that in other ways. The reason why I decided to use this for trading was I was reading about it saying that ChatGPT had all these skills and it knew about all these things up until 2020. So I was like, well, what does it know about finance? So I thought, well, what the perfect thing to predict would be the stock market, right? Like, we all want to know what the next price is going to be. So, hey, maybe this machine learning thing will tell us what the price of the S&P 500 will be tomorrow. Then I said, hey, is it possible to take price data? If I give you the price data for like S&P 500 to make a realistic prediction of the next price using your machine learning. And surprisingly enough, it came back with a response and basically said, yes, it is possible to use AI machine learning to make predictions about the future prices based on past data. In fact, this is a common for all AI in the financial industry. By analyzing the large amounts of data, a machine learning model can learn to identify patterns and trends in data. The model can then use this knowledge to make predictions about the future price. However, it was saying that it's important to note that to make the most accurate predictions about the future, it's very difficult, and there's no guarantee that the machine learning model will be able to make an accurate prediction. I gave it a data set. I said, here's 20 years of S&P data because I wanted to give it a specific data set. A daily price, high, low, close, nothing fancy for the last 20 years. At that point, I was like, hey, here's your data set. You said you could do it. Give me an example using Python how you would predict the price of the S&P 500 going forward. The next thing, ChatGPT comes back and it says, okay, here's an example of how you might use AI machine learning in Python to make a prediction about the future prices. It didn't make the prediction itself. In fact, it would refuse to do it, but it told you, here's how you could program an AI to do it. And it imported all the Python libraries that we currently use, many of these in our Unity trading model. And it basically started pulling stuff that I was familiar with. Immediately started coding an AI machine learning model to look at the data that I gave it. So it looked at the data and it says, yeah, here's the open high, here's the close. And then it's going to define tomorrow's price and the future price. Literally gave me a brief amount of Python code. Now, yeah. I want to say that Python code was not something you could just compile and run immediately. But then it gave me a little report about what it did. For example, it said, this code uses the random parse regressor class from this sklearn library to train a machine learning model to pass price data. The model is then used to make predictions about tomorrow's price based on the open, high, low, and close prices of the previous days. The performance of the model is then evaluated using the mean absolute error function, which calculates the average difference between the price predicted, as you were asking in the previous question, and the true value of what the price ended up being, right? Now, one of the things I noticed immediately was ChatGPT was cheating. It was looking at yesterday's price to tell me what today's price will be. So I said, hey, you've got a problem here. What prevents your model from seeing the next price, the future price, which is tomorrow's price, because you're not like doing anything, right? So then it kind of did an edit. Here's what I could do to prevent myself from seeing tomorrow's price. And it gave me an example of how to train and test and split the data out so that it would only see the current data, not the future data. Oh no, we went back and forth quite a bit because I was like, hey, if it's gonna give me an example in Python, I wanna see this Python code run. So I took its code and started like building it. So I gave it an example and said, in the code you gave me, this was never defined properly. Can you correct that? And sure enough, ChatGPT comes back to me and says, in the previous example, the function was not defined. You are correct. And then see, here's the corrected code for the example. And it started correcting its own code. Going back and forth with chat over several times, it actually did build a version of the Python code that compiled and looked at all the metrics and came back with answers about how well it was doing with its predictions. In the end, it started coming back with the actual predictions about what this model would do and how well it would do. It started defining the absolute error function. And the ultimate value that I got from the first build that actually worked was 0.5. And for this example, this means the average difference between the price predicted and the true value was 0.5. In other words, on average, the model's predictions were 0.5 units away from the true value. Take that into S&P price data. So we're talking like, I think it's like 0.5% is what that means. And it could be up or down. You know, that's a really difficult answer to give you, because when I went back and asked ChatGPT to change things, it would change it pretty fast, and it would be different each time. It was able to compile or aggregate those lines of code in new ways. And it was also able to interpret the code. The answer is yes to your question. Was it looking at code that it had previously seen? But I also do believe it was modifying that code on the fly. As far as our use in Unity for our products and our trading models, the work that we've done over the years, all of us as traders, we've put together some models that work better than what the machine learning has developed in a lot of ways. So yeah, this what I saw it produce was basically following price more than leading price. So kind of like the moving averages follow price. That's the best way to describe it. Whereas I think that something, Wilder's RSI has some predictive ability because it's looking at mean reversion. And of course, maybe I should introduce ChatGPT to mean reversion. I'm sure it could do something different with that. But the fact that something can get too far extended in one direction can create a pullback or something like that, you know, I think is actually more predictive in a lot of ways than what we're seeing here with chat.